Good afternoon. My name is Howard Tipton, and I serve as the County Administrator for St. Lucie County. Today is January 8th, and this is our briefing on both the coronavirus and the vaccine rollout. With me today is Clint Sperber, Health Department Administrator. In terms of the pandemic, we're in month 11, and unfortunately, solidly in a second and stronger wave of the virus at this moment. Looking at the period from December 27th through January 6th, COVID-19 new cases are up 13% and fatalities are up 8%. Both of these are higher than the state average. Looking at the 14-day averages, our communities had come down. Going back to last summer, we were at a high of 13.5% as in terms of our positivity rate. We got that down, that was in July, we got that down to 3.73% in mid-October, not that long ago. This past, as of yesterday, the 14-day average is now 15.41%, and our cases are averaging 190. And give you an idea, we went over 300 for the first time in this since January 1st, one time, and we've been over 200 cases three times in a day since January 1st. So we are by far seeing the highest number of cases that we have seen since the start of this pandemic. We are not at this point looking to close any facilities or modify our operations, but obviously if this trend continues and we begin to see impacts on essential services and our medical facilities, additional steps will have to be considered. We're all anxious to see the vaccine rollout, and we'll discuss that in just a minute. However, we have to remember that this battle with the virus is still going on, and it is still in front of us, and will be for several months yet to come. We've got to do a better job of taking the steps necessary to stay safe. And as we've shared on numerous occasions, we know that this virus needs our help to spread. It has no wings or feet. It requires us to move it around. And so we know the things that we need to do to stay safe. We socially distance, we avoid large gatherings, we wear a face covering, we wash our hands, we stay home if we're sick. These are simple rules. These are not hard to follow. And if we do it, we're going to be in better shape. But right now, the numbers are showing us that we are helping this virus spread. We've got to do better. And so it is a real and present danger in our community. Just want to make sure that everyone understands we are a hotspot right now. This is not a designation that we want. So we can do better and we will do better. So now let's talk a little bit about the vaccine. And for that, I'm going to ask Clint Sperber, our Health Department Administrator, to come forward.
Thank you, Howard. Good afternoon, everyone. And as Howard has mentioned, that our COVID-19 levels are at the highest since the beginning of the pandemic. So again, thank you, Howard, for stressing the importance of mitigation efforts. Now with vaccine. As of January 7th, 384,223 Floridians have received the vaccine. St. Lucie County, we have had 3,646 residents that have received it. Now, the way the vaccine has started to come into the state of Florida, we know that 80% of the vaccine has gone to hospitals and 20% to long-term care facilities and county health departments. So during the first phase of vaccine administration, all providers administering any vaccine are only vaccinating these populations. And this is through the governor's executive order, which is long-term care facility residents and staff, persons 65 years of age and older, and healthcare personnel with direct patient care. We know current supplies are not enough, so please be patient as more vaccines arrive into the state and eventually into St. Lucie County. We have a plan and systems in place to distribute the vaccine to these priority groups, but again, it will take time. Last Monday, the health department received 3,000 doses of the Moderna vaccine and immediately began to work to distribute the vaccine. we were able to transfer 1,300, give or take, doses to a few community partners, including St. Lucie Fire District, Florida Community Health Center, Whole Family Health, and Midway Specialty Care. We set up vaccination clinics in our Milner facility all of this week. We had it scheduled Monday through Friday, and also all of next week we are doing it. Unfortunately, it's by appointment, but all slots have been filled. And the remaining 700 doses, and we'll speak a little bit more about this, but we are planning to do a mass vaccination clinic for frontline healthcare workers tomorrow. This is at St. Lucie County Fairgrounds, located at 15601 Midway Road in Fort Pierce. That's from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. Now, we have sent out news releases last week about it, but again, it's a good opportunity. If you haven't read it and you are watching, if you are a healthcare worker and you have not received your vaccine, to please come out. This week, we received an additional 12,000 plus doses of the Pfizer vaccine and have currently transferred over 3,100 of those doses to Cleveland Clinic Tradition, Midway Specialty Care, Whole Family Health as well. Now, each of these agencies will provide specifics on their website and social media about events that they are scheduling. So as we move forward, and we're essentially in week number two of St. Lucie County through us at the local county health department receiving the vaccine, and we know that we will need the help of the community providers, and they are stepping up as one would expect. Now, next Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, which is January 11th through the 13th, we will also have a drive-up mass vaccination clinic for those 65 years of age and older and healthcare workers. It is going to be from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. per day. Now, unlike Saturday's event, this event and all future events will be made by appointment. To access registration for the event next week and all, again, all future COVID-sponsored events, and when I say sponsored by us at the Florida Department of Health in St. Lucie, I ask you to please visit our health department website. That address is stlucie.floridahealth.gov. On that page, you will see a link to register for COVID vaccine events. Please follow the prompts and instructions on the link. Also, it's important to be aware that slots will fill up quickly. Once they are filled up for any particular event, you will have an ability to add yourself to a wait list. Please only use the link on our website. What's important to remember, it's free to register and the vaccine will be free as well. We will also continue to work with our community partners to provide vaccines to those 65 and older. In St. Lucie County alone, looking at the 2019 U.S. Census, we know that there are over 80,000 residents who fall into this category. So it will take time for us to provide vaccine to every individual who wants it, who is part of this priority group. I would also like to recognize Indian River State College, the nursing program, and Florida State University School of Medicine for agreeing to partner with us to help vaccinate St. Lucie residents. In closing, I want to emphasize we are working closely with the hospitals, medical providers, public safety, response partners, local officials to make sure we push vaccine into the community as quickly as we receive it. Thank you.
I saw a meme yesterday and it said, I'd like to cancel my subscription to 2021. My 7-day free trial was enough. It's a humorous thought and some sad commentary, but the reality is that we are in fact in 2021 and we are committed and dedicated to making this year better than last year. This will require hard work and a continued commitment to safety, and relating back to the vaccine rollout, a lot of patience. Our commitment is to roll out safely and efficiently. It's something new, and so as this rolls out, there's going to be a learning curve. But our goal is to, as we get new vaccine supplies in, we turn it around through a variety of medical resources, as Clint explained, and get it out to the public and the community. We've had few, if any, negative reactions so far that I'm aware of, which is great news. And with a 90% efficacy rate, it's important that a large percentage of our population get this vaccine. We appreciate the enthusiasm. The vaccine is the path out of this pandemic, and although we don't have a schedule from the state or the pharmaceutical companies, we're hopeful to see additional shipments arriving into our community over the coming weeks and months, and we will turn around and get those out. So our message to you right now, in light of everything, stay positive and test negative. Thank you, and if there are any questions, we're happy to take them.
You said you're seeing the highest number of cases since the start of the pandemic. Why do you think that's the case?
Well, I'm sure there's a lot of reasons. We see a lot of people coming to Florida right now, and so we are kind of in the season, and so we have a lot of snowbirds coming down. We have a lot of travelers from other areas. Certainly, there are a lot of other areas that are hot as well. And then we're coming off of the holidays, and we know that there were a lot of gatherings over the holidays, and so we expected to see a bump. We just don't know how high this one's going to go. I think those are some of the reasons. We also have the new variant out there, right? And we know that that was detected in Martin County, but that was through a random sample. And so we know that it's here as well. And so you have to treat everybody as if they're hot. Treat everybody as if they might have it and act accordingly.
What is your biggest fear if these numbers don't go down?
Fear is the impact on our medical facilities. We talked at the very beginning, going back to March, about flattening the curve and making sure that our healthcare facilities didn't get overwhelmed. We only have to look at what's going on in Southern California right now to imagine what that might look like. And people say, well, you know, I don't really want to go to the hospital, or I don't need to go to the hospital. But you don't know when you might need to, or you might have an accident and need to be transported to the hospital. You don't know if you might be diagnosed with something that would cause you to go to the hospital. We're all concerned. We should all have a concern about our hospital capacities. We've got some great partners in our medical community. Our hospitals are part of systems, and so they have the ability to move things around and prioritize. And so we have capacity today. We're just trying to look forward and say, as we did early on in this, that if we can flatten this curve, if we can keep these numbers down, we know the process. New cases equal greater hospitalizations, equal greater fatalities. That's the process that this goes through. Okay, if we can knock down the new cases, we'll have an impact downstream on both hospitalizations and fatalities, and that's the focus.
And again, what is your hospital capacity as of today?
I don't have that current number. I know last week we had capacity. I don't know the percentages, but we were in okay shape, but we had seen a dramatic increase in the number of COVID patients.
I don't know if this question will be for Clint or for you, Howard. How many doses of the Moderna vaccine do you have right now?
So we had 3,000 delivered to us earlier. So you mean how many do we have on hand?
Correct.
I think we only have 700 left, correct? That's what we'll be distributing tomorrow at the healthcare worker event.
And the event next week, Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, for the general public, I believe, at 65 and older, that's already been spoken for?
Yes, I think so.
Yes. So when
and that's the Pfizer vaccine. So we're talking about the two different vaccines. The Pfizer vaccine is what we will be distributing next week.
And that's already booked. The appointment's already booked.
Yes.
Will they open up today?
They open up today and they booked already today?
Yeah. Go. Okay. We'll let Clint answer that one. Yeah.
No problem. I'm sorry for holding this.
So the question was for next week, the event. We are opening it up on our website. It is open right now. It's called Eventbrite. So when you go to our website, look, scroll down to the middle of the page and click on that link, and you can register for the event. So as Howard was mentioning, we are using Pfizer vaccine for that event. And our anticipation is to vaccinate approximately 1,500 people per day. And it will be, the way that we're doing it by appointment is between 9 and 3, we'll have 500 appointments available every 2 hours. So that's how it's going to be scheduled. And then in the future, with all future events, as more vaccine comes in, we do want to use a proven system with appointments. It just helps manage it a lot easier.
So for people who may be listening to this news conference right now, they go on the website, sign up for next week, I'm guessing that will probably go pretty quickly. Do they have another choice? Can they go to their physician and they may have a vaccine there as well? Can they go to the Midway Clinic and they have vaccine as well?
Yeah, so all good questions. With the distribution that we currently have done, and again, this is in week two, through Cleveland Clinic, some with Midway Specialty Care, some with Whole Family Health, that there are very limited supplies, and they are also going to offer it to the general public as well. But again, limited supplies, and as far as the registration process, I would definitely recommend following up on their website and social media. It might be out there right now, or if not, stay tuned in the next day or two as they are able to ramp up and have a strategy to vaccinate probably beginning early next week, if not over the weekend. But what's important to please emphasize and help us is the vaccine supplies coming into the state of Florida and then eventually making its way down here, they are coming through the pharmaceutical companies. So from a planning perspective, we learn about these allocations maybe a week in advance. So again, it's going to be patience. It's going to be very similar to the way testing started. Is we know that there weren't enough testing locations and tests available in the beginning of the pandemic, but eventually it opened up and there are a lot of places where you can get tests in this county and throughout the entire state. And we know through the governor and his many initiatives of working with the pharmaceutical companies and the other retail outlets such as Walgreens and CVS, because they're partnering to vaccinate our long-term care facilities. He does have a pilot project, he being the governor, working through Publix's in central part of Florida. And we know it's going to expand. There's going to be a lot more avenues in the very near future to get more vaccine. You will see some state-sponsored clinics popping up, and we don't know when or where, but we know those are also going to. So it's going to be several different venues that the general public, well, first the priority groups, and then when that opens up, and I don't know when that would be, that eventually there will be a lot more vaccine. And as mentioned between Howard and myself, demand is fantastic, and it's a good thing because we know this is how we will beat the viruses, by vaccinating the population. But please be patient. As supplies come through several different ways, we will push it out through the media and set our community partners to let the general public know.
And Clint, can you explain the difference between the two websites, the St. Lucie Alert and compared to this website you just mentioned, that where they need to go and actually sign up to try and get an appointment for next week?
Okay, I can, with the website for signing up for vaccination clinics, that is gonna be through our Department of Health website. So when we know we have a planned event, that will be on our website. And this is an event that we are sponsoring just through our local county health department. With Alert St. Lucie, it's been around for years and years. I know that there's been many people who have signed up to receive all types of notifications about what's going on in the county. And this is just another benefit from having a resource in the county where we could push out information. So it's just another avenue to help push information, whether it's a vaccination clinic that is a partner agency that we're joining on, or different events that we learn about throughout the entire county. It's an avenue that we can share information.
So we should promote that website, the county website, for people to call if we make an appointment.
Yes.
The county website is for future appointments. To sign up for an appointment for next week, it would be the health department website.
Yes. But it is to sign up for next week, but you can also put your name down on a wait list, and it will generate an email to let you know when other events are also open. So the recommendation is do both. Sign up for Alert St. Lucie to learn about not only events that we're hosting, but other events that might be going on across the entire county that the local health department is not part of.
Thank you. Todd, do you have anything? All right, we're good.
All right, next we will do this same presentation in Spanish and then in Creole.
Buenas tardes. Hoy es viernes 8 de enero y este es el reporte más reciente de COVID-19 del condado de San Lucie. Hasta esta mañana, nuestro condado había reportado 16,613 casos de contagio y 424 personas han fallecido. En semanas recientes, hemos notado un incremento en los contagios del 16% de casos positivos. Le pedimos a la comunidad no bajar la guardia, continuar observando el distanciamiento social, el uso de mascarillas y lavarse las manos con bastante frecuencia. Si está enfermo, por favor, quédese en su casa, llame a su médico y hágase la prueba del COVID. Para ver los lugares donde puede hacerse la prueba, por favor, visite www.stlucieco.org/COVID-19 y también recoversanlucie.org. Las vacunas contra el COVID están siendo distribuidas en todo el estado de la Florida. El Departamento de Seguridad Pública de nuestro condado está trabajando con el Departamento de Salud para proveer vacunas a las personas en la lista de prioridad establecida por el gobernador de la Florida, la cual incluye residentes y empleados de hogares de ancianos, trabajadores de la salud y personas mayores de 65 años de edad. Las personas que deseen recibir la vacuna deben comunicarse con su médico, ya que es posible que algunas facilidades médicas reciban las vacunas antes que el Departamento de Salud. Para informarse sobre las fechas de las clínicas de vacunación, los residentes deben llamar al Departamento de Salud al 772-446-8480 o registrarse a Alert San Lucie para ser notificado por email o mensaje de texto visitando a www.sanlucieco.gov/alert. El condado de San Lucie es uno de los 14 condados del estado que tiene capacidades de congeladores ultrafríos para mantener las vacunas, pero la demanda es muy alta y las cantidades son limitadas. En este condado existe un total de 28 proveedores de vacuna, pero con 80,000 residentes en edad promedio de 65 años, tardará algún tiempo para que las vacunas sean distribuidas y administradas a todos. Por favor, recuerde que la vacuna completa requiere de 2 dosis. No importa el tipo de vacuna que usted se ponga. Las farmacias CVS y Walgreens están operando en coordinación con el gobierno federal para vacunar a los residentes y empleados de las facilidades de cuidado a largo plazo. El Departamento de Salud del condado está administrando vacunas por cita solamente. Para hacer una cita, por favor llame al 772-446-8480 o puede buscar disponibilidad visitando la página stlucie.floridahealth.gov. En adición, Cleveland Clinic ha estado administrando aproximadamente 210 vacunas diarias por cita solamente, pero al momento todas las reservaciones están llenas. Para más información, visite my.clevelandclinic.org. A medida que más información se haga disponible, la publicaremos en www.recoversanlucie.org y www.stlucie.gov/COVID-19. Este proceso requerirá mucho trabajo y dedicación. Estamos comprometidos a distribuir las vacunas con eficacia y seguridad. Esto es algo nuevo, lo cual requerirá tiempo para familiarizarse, pero nuestra meta es que tan pronto recibamos las vacunas, hacerlas disponibles a los recursos médicos de nuestra comunidad y al público. Hasta ahora, no hemos tenido reacciones negativas y con una eficacia del 90%, es muy importante que un gran porcentaje de la comunidad sea vacunado. Las vacunas son el camino para salir de esta pandemia y aunque no tenemos un calendario del estado o de las farmacéuticas, Tenemos fe de que pronto veremos más cargamentos de vacuna llegando a nuestra comunidad en las próximas semanas o meses. Le pedimos que por favor continúen observando las normas para combatir el COVID y que tenga paciencia, ya que puede tomar semanas o hasta meses en lo que se completa el proceso de vacuna local, estatal y nacional. Esto concluye nuestro reporte. Por favor, continúe cuidándose. Gracias.
Bon après-midi, Pep Haïtien. Comme matin, compte Sainte-Lucie te gagne 16 613 cas positifs à 425 fatalités. Dans la dernière semaine qui passait, nous avons un pourcentage positif nous augmenté 16%. Tant pis, pas quitter garde ou descendre. Continuez à faire distance sociale, mettez un couvertine dans la figure, les obaka kembe distance sociale. Et puis, lavez-moi. Si vous êtes malade, retirez la caille, le docteur et puis, cherchons test COVID-19. Vous pouvez joindre côté pour Tesla dans www.stlucieco.gov/COVID-19 et www.recoverstlucie.org. Vaccin COVID-19 est distribué dans tout État. Sécurité publique contre Saint-Lucien a travaillé avec le département de santé pour les gens qui sont sous liste priorité gouverneur. Ça, c'est facilité qui prend soin de monde avec tous les résidents et employés. Travailler soins santé avec les gens qui ont l'âge 65 en plus. N'importe monde qui veut recevoir un vaccin, tu dois contacter le docteur parce que parfois, facilité médicale car recevoir vaccin avant le département de santé local. Pour chercher qui clinique vaccin masse, qui est vaccin masse pour le faire, relève le département de santé dans 772-446-84-80. Ou soit inscrit dans Alert Saint Lucie, vous voyez une notification par email ou soit texte dans www.stlucieco.gov/alert. Saint Lucie, c'est une dans 14 comptes dans l'État Floride qui gagne ultra fouette capacité pour y obtenir vaccin. Demande la 3 ou mais équipement yo limité. Gen 28 fournis vaccins dans compte Saint-Lucie, mais nous gagnons 80 000 résidents dans l'âge plus que 65 ans. L'Ipoil prend quelques temps pour vaccin yo distribuer et administrer pour tout le monde. Temps pour changer pour vaccin complet, tout le monde a besoin de faire point de vaccin quel que soit qualité vaccin yo recevoir. CVS et pharmacie Walgreens a opéré pour yo bay résidents soins en temps et employé vaccin. Saint-Lucie département santé a administré vaccin par rendez-vous seulement. Pour faire un rendez-vous, relève 772-446-8480 ou soit visitez www.stlucie.floridahealth.gov. En plus de ça, Clinique Cleveland commence à administrer presque 210 vaccins chaque jour par rendez-vous seulement. Mais pour Kounia, rendez-vous yo plein. Pour plus d'informations, visitez www.myclevelandclinic.org. Les plus d'informations des vaccins disponibles ou pour les joindre informations dans www.recoverstlucie.org et www.stlucieco.gov/COVID-19. Nous demandons pour tout le monde de continuer à suivre la directive COVID-19 et puis faire patience parce que pour avoir plusieurs semaines ou soit plusieurs mois pour nous distribuer tout le vaccin. Ça va demander pour tout le monde de travailler. Pour nous continuer à rester en sécurité et puis faire patience, les NAP distribuer le vaccin. Ça, c'est un processus nouveau, mais l'objectif, nous, c'est pour nous recevoir équipement vaccin et faire disponible par ressources médicales dans la communauté pour tout public. Là. Nous n'avons pas aucune réaction négative. Ça, c'est une belle nouvelle parce que nous gagnons un pourcentage 90. L'important pour nous, pour plus gros pourcentage de la population jouent vaccin. Vaccin, c'est chemin qui sortit dans la pandémie. Nous pas gagnons oreille qui sorti dans état ou soit compagnie pharmacie. Mais nous espérons que embarquement additionnel rivé dans communauté a nous dans ces maintenant ak moi k'ap vini yo. Songez rete en sécurité, rete positif et testé négatif. Merci beaucoup.